Today we're cutting wood. We're back. I really wanted to play Fable 2. So I'm cutting wood today. We're at Bower Lake, so we're going to have to fast travel real quick. This is an unscheduled stream. I haven't, of course, nothing scheduled now. I deleted Twitter off my phone. How much money did I make since yesterday? Game. Here we go. Jobs. Fuck! The one time. The one fucking time. Oh my god. Fine. I guess we're not doing that. Fuck. Okay, adjusting the stream. Okay, regular intro then. Hello, everybody. We're back with Fable 2. I was gonna do woodcutting today, but apparently I'm not allowed to. The game just gave me a massive middle finger. I could have swore there was a fucking woodcutting job. But, you know, we're going into the guild. But we're taking the long way. We're not fast traveling. God, my bitrate's abysmal. Because there is something... Well, there's a few things that I need to do that require me to go the long way to the guild. Fucking Beatles. Oh boy, already XP stuck under the ground. I don't remember that chest being there. I vaguely remember there being a chest here after the time skip. Alright, let's see what's in here. Strength potion. Awesome. It'd be really nice if they'd fucking add a way to get the chicken suit in this game. Because there's achievements connected to that damn outfit. And it's impossible to fucking obtain. Because the website used to get it is shut down now. They added the fucking Halo shit in as DLC. I mean, aside from the tattoos... I'm pretty sure this place doesn't change, like, whatsoever. There's just a few things I couldn't get before. I didn't prepare coffee, so, woof. What is my fucking dog doing? I think my dog's stuck. Here, this should lure him out. There we go. Good boy. Good boy, Coda. what's his name here? I should probably get my dog's treasure hunting to max before the last mission. And then go exploring. Hello to the whoever the two people are that are watching. The stream was unplanned. I just felt like playing Fable 2. I don't like beetles. There's like, I think at least one gargoyle in here. I've already been in there. Taste my lightning, fucker! In here. Kill a white die. I knew I could find that stuff. You guys are fucking lame. I guess we're quoting Tenacious D a bunch today. Bewitching augment. Not the most useful augment.
Don't you try and ignore me.
There we go. Where is he? You are who I was looking for. I don't think there's really anything else that I needed. I was primarily just coming back for the gargoyle, but I knew I'd have missed a few pieces of treasure here and there. Ow. Killing beetles is really fun in this game. Inferno. Though I am aiming for blades, because maxed out blades I think, gives you 6 blades. What I really should be doing is drinking will XP potions during this, because they actually do increase the amount of XP you gain when you fight. Oh, that was quick. Come on. There we go. I don't think anything new will be in here. I'm gonna check anyway. Alright, hurry up. Where is it? I think he's confused. Yeah. Books. It's the same books every time, I think. Yep. Actually, you know what I should do? Lucian's diary. We're listening to that now.
Tonight, I look down on the mobs crowding the barstone streets and feel a dark, bitter envy. I covet their comfort, their vibrancy, their life. Fairfax Castle is silent. My dear Helena, my cherished Amelia, I miss you both. There's no more certain cure for pain than anger, and I'm filled with enough of that to bring the world to a smoldering halt, that people would accept death and despair as part of life, as fate is beyond my comprehension. I find myself wanting to shout into their ignorant faces, to shake them out of their complacency, for surely they are insane. This world and every living thing in it must surely be insane. I resumed my research today. I can read for an hour to stretch before that dark cloud descends upon my mind once more. The moments of clarity I have must suffice, I think. Perhaps in these papers I can find something that will ease my suffering, and even that of others. I am no longer alone in my research. Garth is from the western reaches of Samarkand, and his work far outstrips my own. He shows a remarkable facility with Old Kingdom artifacts. Today I have watched in wonder as lights, delicately spun like cobwebs, shimmered in solid stone. Remarkable. I have discovered that by the end of their reign, the Archons of the Old Kingdom faced their own mortality with anger. They came to reject the inevitability of death. That we share at least this philosophy is some comfort. They made great efforts to change their world, great efforts. When I mentioned this to Garth, he grew silent. I wonder at this. Images of the tattered spire are now burned into my mind. It is the sun looked upon for too long, the melody that echoes ceaselessly. I found it! The key to a new world! I pray that I have the will to do what I must. Garth finally capitulated. Together we took a frigate to the site and sent down drag lines. We circled the area for a week, growing more irritable with each day. Then today, our lines hit stone. It is there. It is deep, unfathomably deep. And yet, the task is not impossible. It must not be. There is no alternative. Enforced labor is the only way the spire can be completed within my lifetime. Garth shares my apprehension at this prospect, but I believe he shares my determination as well. Sometimes conventional notions of morality must be subverted, suspended, no matter how difficult that may be. Morality is a fine thing. Taken to its logical extreme, it can hold us back from true greatness. Perhaps Westcliff is the answer to the enforcement dilemma. Crucible winners must be of particularly sturdy stock, ideal recruits, physically. As for issues of obedience, I believe I may have found an answer to any dissatisfaction that might develop once they're here. I cannot allow anything to compromise the spire's construction. Blood seems to be the key. In particular, those whose lineage can be traced back to the ancient line. But where do I find such folk? Can their ancestry be determined with the naked eye? It strikes me that I've not made sufficient note of Garth's peculiarities before now. I shall inquire. Blood seems to be the key. In particular, those whose lineage can be traced back to the ancient line. But where do I find such folk? Can their ancestry be determined with the naked eye? It strikes me that I've not made sufficient note of Garth's peculiarities before now. I shall inquire.
I fucked up.
I feel an unexpected joy at being so far out from the mainland. Here I can imagine that no other ties bind me to this world. No past, no pain, just the great task before me. Now the base is almost complete. Our ships will have a harbor at least. Sadly, today saw the first of our workers fall. This was not unexpected. We must continue regardless. Blood seems to be the key. In particular, those whose lineage can be traced back to the ancient mine. But Where do I find such folk? Can their ancestry be determined with the naked eye? It strikes me that I've not made sufficient note of Garth's peculiarities before now. I shall inquire. I feel an unexpected joy at being so far out from the mainland. Here I can imagine that no other ties bind me to this world. No past,
I think I broke
no
it.
Pain, just the great task before me. Now the base is almost complete. Our ships will have a harbor at least. Sadly, today saw the first of our workers fall. This was not unexpected. We must continue regardless.
Okay, it's not completely broken. Let me make sure this is the right one. Okay, yeah.
Each month, it becomes harder to imagine a return to mundane duties. The spire whispers to me, still faint, but already somehow familiar and comforting. As I lay a hand upon walls that are only now beginning to take shape, I can almost feel the heartbeat of those that came before us. Today, the peace was interrupted briefly by a minor uprising. I had no choice but to deal with it harshly. I do not begrudge the men who stood against me. They do not understand, but they will learn in time. Garth informs me that four workers leapt to their death this morning. It is regrettable, and yet I must remain focused. The work is what matters. In fact, I wonder if we should not be less discriminating when it comes to the recruitment of labor. Our progress seems less a function of their efforts and their skill than of their sheer weight in numbers. I shall forgo the use of collars on these men. I believe more traditional forms of discipline will be just as efficient. Today, I felt the first stirrings of will. It was unlike anything I've ever experienced. Powerful, seductive, and all too brief. I hunger for more. Garth seemed displeased. Beware hubris was all he could think to say. It is becoming clear to me that his thinking, while brilliant, is often conflicted and timid. Can you not grasp the beauty of what we shall accomplish? My beloved Helena and Amelia still visit me whenever I close my eyes. But last night, my dreams were unlike any that have haunted me before. I saw a blind, hooded woman and other figures, shadowed and gaunt. But sunrise has already stripped us of any meaning it may have held. Is this all my new abilities have to offer? Cryptic visions and prophetic riddles? I'd sooner enjoy a full night of rest. One question has consumed me of late. If the spire and its component parts react to will, would not small slivers of the spire within a man grant him heroic powers? I had prepared an experiment to test this arresting theory, only for Garth's interruption to ruin it. He's becoming a greater impediment the further we progress. Yet I have no thought of removing him. Once indispensable for his intellect alone, he is now crucial to this great project in ways he may not even suspect. I hope he does not. My life and my purpose lie far beyond Albion's shores now. I shall not stay long in the castle that bears my name. My facility with the technology of the ancients increases exponentially. And today I learned of two promising candidates right here within the city. Could it be that two of the titans I seek are right under my nose? They're only children, but... My dear Amelia.
it. And that's the end of Lucien's journal. I could have swore there were like fucking a few more pages. But let's continue with the story.
Did you see Hammer? She is on her way as well, with the information she's gathered.
Our friend has told me much about you. That night in the castle, your sister, I had no idea. If I'd known, I would have stopped him.
Sorry it took me so long. Lucien's men are all over the place.
You must be Hammer.
And you must be Garth, Lucien's lackey.
I was made to understand you might be mistrustful. I didn't anticipate your staggering wit and intellect.
Oh yeah? And did you anticipate that I like to take a hammer and whack smug little spell flingers?
This is not what we're here for. Hammer has information on the third hero.
Mostly gathered from a tavern, I hear.
Not one, lots of them. I did a proper tour. Right. I think this bloke, the thief, is a pirate called Reaver. He runs the port of Bloodstone to the southwest.
And you got this from some drunk?
Yeah. He sailed with Reaver for years. Said they captured hundreds of ships.
Doesn't mean he's a hero. Lots of pirates capture ships.
Reaver takes down galleons with one bullet. High winds, rough seas, a mile away, doesn't matter. He picks off the captain. The more impossible the shot, the quicker the crew surrenders.
Impressive. But we're not trying to make Lucien surrender.
No, we're not.
Bloodstone is surrounded by Wraith Marsh on three sides, and ocean on the fourth.
No matter. We can reach it via Collis Gate.
Not this one. It leads only to Hero Hill.
Got another one handy, have you?
I built one at my tower. It can get us to Wraithmarsh.
Okay, you're a genius. Does it work?
It will take some time to activate, but it should work.
Should?
You must do this together. Lucien has sent men to guard Brightwood Tower.
Okay, then let's go. After you, your brilliance.
Barbarian.
Alright, let's hurry up. I'm actually gonna stop by Bowerstone first. Hey, kitty. First to Bowerstone Market to buy potions and possibly sleep. And then we go to Brightwood. Oh, is it already morning? Hot damn!
I like
not the little savages
toy.
You usually see.
You, oh, buy this piece of shit good. Off of me.
Come back if you have anything else to sell.
And the alchemist is closed. Wonderful. I'm sure he'll take 3 fucking years getting to there. Getting to his shop, because nobody ever shows up on time.
Customer.
I'm not your favorite customer, you moron. I'm your employee, or I'm your employer. I need this.
That's a good buy.
And I need this.
Oh, you won't regret buying that.
Because I have, like, a couple pounds on me. Also, I need to heal.
If you spend lots of gold, I can.
Where the hell is that?
Shops now open to the public.
Here, this will help.
Shops are now opening.
God damn, take your time getting to work.
You're it now.
Can't catch me.
Sell me potions.
You're my favorite customer. Come back anytime. That's a fine item. There you go. It's Lionheart. How's it going?
And now we go do the quest. Also fire.
We shouldn't use the front gate. Lucien's men will be expecting us. Follow me. I know another way in.
It really is great to have you back. I went back to the temple for a while. Same old nonsense. Ignorant men trying to tell everyone how to live their lives based on books written 1,000 years ago.
Right. Nothing that ancient could possibly contain any wisdom.
Hey, these aren't old kingdom schematics that teach you how to build guns that shoot lightning. It's a load of superstitious nonsense that never helped anybody. And if you swallow it all, it can get you killed.
Hmm. We may actually be in agreement there. But let's cut this short. We have a lot to do.
Satisfaction guaranteed.
I should probably get coffee. Oh, I just realized I'm about to go to Bloodstone. That means I can open this demon door here. Unless the game just decides to not have dreadlocks at any of the barbers.
Lucien's men, they're looking for me. They're between us and the Cullis Gate. We'll have to fight our way through.
Just how I like it.
All right, let's go.
Let's fight!
Damn, Garth.
Let's
You fucking jumped. Just a little bit of XP left.
Hold your weapons.
Die.
Die.
Really, because I've killed quite a few soldiers in Lib.
We are prepared for the use of them.
Not prepared enough, though.
It serves as a warning to you all.
Not so entertaining when I can hit back, is it?
Ooh, that's got bad implications.
You're too fast.
Fireball! Ow!
What's the matter? I'm not amusing anymore?
We'll come back for that chest later. Oh, and after this, I can get the best weapon in the game. Oh boy. Ow! I feel like those things are supposed to be a lot harder to destroy. Oh god. Soldiers are spawning now. God damn, they fucked my dog up. Here, boy. Upstairs.
Need to concentrate to start the gate. I must rely on the two of you to watch my back.
Oh, sure. We'll do all the work while you sit there and think. Let me know when it's my turn for a break, will you? Is that a shard?
Amazing, isn't it?
Get a better look at this thing.
A sunset's amazing. That thing's a bloody nightmare.
We have a small advantage. They don't want us dead.
They're coming up the stairs. I know that's
yeah.
To be comforting.
Small.
But it's not alone. Looks like it's brought its own army.
God damn, they fucked Garth up. Let's make sure they don't. Die, bitch! God damn it.
Chop that worm up.
I'll focus on the soldier. You focus on the guards and keeping Garth alive. I just did. And I'll do it again. I don't appreciate how much damage you do. God damn.
We're close. Just a few more adjustments.
Ow. Yes, thank you for actually doing something, Hammer. That means I can aim. Or I can sub-target.
I know.
Don't let up now. I'm almost finished.
Stop fucking dying. Go, 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 go. And we're finally here. Oh, dear God! Ow.
Can you hear me?
What? The portal Yamcha'd me.
Well, well, well. What have we got here? Is it alive? You had a dog with you there, like. It ran off into the fog. The banshees will have it by now. Aye, you've seen the last of that mongrel, I can tell you. You from Bloodstone, eh? No, you ain't got the stink of it about you. 'Tis a wicked place. Would be burnt to the ground if there was any justice. So, What do I do about you? Reckon I'll burn you as well.
What was that shaking?
You should be able to hear me now. You're alive. The Colors Gate malfunctioned, and Hammer and Garth were sent back to the Guild. You've made it to Wraithmarsh, but you're on your own for now. Well, you're not entirely on your own, but Hammer and Garth cannot reach you. Be wary. The fog here is unnatural. Somehow it dampens the Guild seal. Bloodstone is on the far side of the marshes. I suggest you head there, quickly.
Good boy. The game's auto-saving. You deserve a treat for that. Let's check the area out. Windmill. Chest down there. We'll go to that in a minute. Here's the Cullis Gate I came out at. Here's a demon door.
Art thou perchance a devotee of mine? I have performed all the great plays, entertained kings and paupers. But doth anyone care anymore? Just because the great Philip Morley called me the greatest actor of his generation, he wrote several of his greatest works with me in mind, you know. And now here I am, abandoned to a world of Philistines and unsophisticates. I ask only for an audience to witness my talents one last time, so that I may pierce their souls with arrows of pure art. I lack neither.
This demon door is surprisingly only a mild pain in the ass to get, open. Which you'd expect, having to bring 10 people to a door in the middle of nowhere would be an even bigger pain in the ass. Ooh, a very good health potion.
I'd ask you to try shooting me, but you'd probably poke your eye out instead.
I hear a gargoyle. God damn, he got fucked up. Where are you? There you are. It's a surprise you can find anything here. You can also sleep in these beds, which is funny. You'd think these beds would be unusable. Because, you know, you're in the middle of a haunted swamp. It's daytime now. Should be... something over here, I believe. Yes, a chest. You're not imagining that. The screen is shaking violently. You'll see why here in a minute. Another gargoyle, and another spot to dig up.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sunshine yellow dye.
You think you're smart? I've seen more brains in a slop bucket.
Say something else. Seriously, it's funny. Say something. Fine, you're no fun. Almost halfway there.
Something in the marsh is controlling the fog and using it against you. You need to find the source and destroy it.
I think I found it. Wood. No!
Well done. But be careful. There may be more, so stay on your guard. I may lose contact with you again because of the fog.
Also, plenty of hollow men are out here. Yeah, banshees are normally supposed to be really difficult enemies to face. But as I learned from my brother, you can pretty much beat them with 2 level 4 fireballs. The Hollowman shaking the environment is very distracting. Ooh, a toy gun. It's an evil toy gun. I don't think there's anything in this house. The screen shaking is very distracting. Game stop. I don't like this. Hang on, I know where to go to kill them. I think I already went in here. No, I did not. Fun thing, they can't get to me because they're spawning outside of this area. And enemies will despawn or lose interest if they can't get to you within a certain, like, radius. Oh! See? I'm right outside of their range. Yeah, I'm gonna go around and destroy these assholes. So I can actually get the screen shaking to stop! Die, bitch. Off with your head. Come on, give me that XP. I know there's some under the ground. No? Alright, I'm not waiting. If they ever do a remake of this game, I hope they fix that issue. I'm not gonna bother. I think I fucking missed a few things in that house, but it's not really worth going in.
This used to be Oakvale, though it has changed radically since I saw it last. And that was a long time ago. It has seen many a cruel deed. 600 years ago, bandits attacked the village and burned it to the ground. The survivors rebuilt their lives, only to have them destroyed a second and final time. A new threat came from within. A reckless young villager made a deal with the forces of Shadow, who took the lives of every other resident as payment. All of his family, all of his friends, everyone he loved. And now, the marsh has engulfed the village, and Oakvale is nothing but a bitter memory.
I think this place has seen, like, the most drastic change between Fable 1 and 2. Like, not just because it's a completely different area, technically speaking, but because, like, the layout of this place has completely changed. That's a big-ass building.
See your aim.
I hear you, you little shit. Also Hollow Men. What's in here again? Haha, you ain't got no weapons. Boop, got your spine. How did the XP get all the way over there? Jesus. You got fucked up. There's the Hollow Man I disarmed earlier. I'm getting a lot of health potions. Oh boy. I forgot they give you that one for a reason. Give me all the Will XP.
Progress. You're about halfway through the marshes now. You'll be in Bloodstone before you know it.
See, like I said, halfway there. Boom. Headshot. Elder Hollow Man, that's what that said. These guys are a little bit of a pain in the ass. Because they take a lot of damage. And also they can use lightning on you. Ow. And they do a lot of damage. That too. Key. I think there's something in here too. No. Is there a gargoyle around here? There's something else around here, I know that. Just not sure what. Yeah, I'll figure it out later.
You're more of a crackpot than a crackpot.
Ah, there is a gargoyle. It's just further. Away than I thought. Okay, that's it. I believe. Oh. There's something down here, I know that. Or maybe there isn't. Maybe I'm just dumb. There's another banshee coming up.
Very impressive. Few survive banshee attacks. You're nearly there, nearly safe.
Come on. Whatever. There is a little bit of an Easter egg over here, as well as a silver key. The unknown traitor perished in a bandit attack. Here lies the charred remains of an Oakvale villager. Brom perished in the bandit attack. Rosie, a teddy bear. Those are all characters you encounter at, like, the very beginning of the game. In the first, game. Bork. Bork. More money. Bork. What? Stop being stuck on a wall. What is it? Yeah. It's a mood ring. The fuck? Oh, there's the troll. How did he take so much damage? Miss me. Fun thing. He can't get you with that attack from the bridge. This is cheating. There we go. I hate swamp trolls especially because they have like three grubs on their back that you have to shoot. There's a silver key over here, but I cannot get to it until later in the game. Last stop before... I hate how it's been doing that. I cast Fireball. This opens up later. Yeah, weirdest route to anywhere ever. To get to Bloodstone, you have to go through a crypt.
Town center is over the next rise.
Yes, but before I go there... Oh, wait, no.
Factory. Wait. I sense the presence of a lute player. Could it really be? Real music at last.
Yes, and I will play it for you later. For now, For now, I need to do the thing. Yes, I have 15 keys, and I believe there's like a master sword in this chest. Oh no, it's a gold touch augment. Right, the master sword is in the demon door.
The largest house in Bloodstone, that'll be Reaver's. I suggest you go and make the thief's acquaintance.
I will do as such. Oh, steel flintlock pistol right there. I knew there was a weapon buried around here somewhere. And this, I think, just has, like, a highwayman's hat or something in it. Yep. Which is kind of dumb, because there's already a place where you can get the highwayman's hat. Blood from a stone. With a name like that, I just gotta buy this place. More stuff to dig up. Fumbling skill potion. That's hilarious. Well, I'm here and people already want to give me gifts.
Hey, wonderful. Want a gift? Hello, Lionheart.
People already know who I am.
Keep it in, will ya?
Take a punt. It's fun. Amaze friends and foes with a dashing title.
Pass the time with my amazing past.
You're the greatest.
I don't even know who you are. What's buried over here again?
I've been watching you, and I like what I see.
I'm going to set you on fire if you don't go away.
Hope all is well, hero.
Oh yeah, speaking of fire, let's fix this.
Hey, mate, you got business with Reaver?
He's through the back.
Well, hello there. Always a nice surprise to have company. I don't get many visitors to my little coastal paradise. Especially ones who might well redefine a man's concept of paradise. You little minx. On the rare occasions that people make it through Wraithmarsh, they're lost, confused, scared. But not you. You are looking for someone. And if you're looking for someone in Bloodstone, let's be honest, you're looking for me. But I'm afraid I hate wasting time on nobodies. That's you. Tell you what. Why don't you go out and rescue some travelers, or slay some beasts, or slay some travelers? The details are unimportant. But prove to me that you're worth dealing with, and you'll have my full attention. That's it. Scoot. Off you go. Vamos. Geweg. Allez-vous-en!
Do you think my buttocks look like that?
Dick.
There's nothing for it. We need his help, and he wants to play his little game. So you must play it.
or Lucien will soon get what he wants. With the Cullis Gate inoperable, Wraithmarsh cuts you off from the rest of the world. If you need to leave Bloodstone, perhaps a sea captain would give you passage.
All right. There are jobs available. Oh, so now it becomes available. Fucking Christ. All right, well, we're doing this tomorrow. The thing that I was going to do this whole time... I should probably check on my wife. Alright, we're gonna check on my wife, then we're gonna call it a night. Well, wife and son. Alright. Let's go. Oh, I make 1600 even. That's nice. Woman, I am home.
Dad! You're back! Yes!
Hey, kiddo.
I love our house.
Let's see, do I have gifts for my wife? Yes, I have a very nice necklace.
Oh, you're so sweet, dear.
Cool, let's go on an adventure. That's just smart.
I also have gifts for my little boy. Alright. Toy gun.
What?
And toy bow.
Cool toy. Thanks. I'm going to be a guard when I grow up. It looks easy.
Oh, I doubt it is. But nothing easy is worth doing. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and call it a night. Tomorrow...
Oh, I thought you'd never come back. I missed you.
Tomorrow, I will be...
Not so fast.
I don't know what I'm gonna do tomorrow.
We're so lucky to have such
a
happy little boy.
We have so much food to eat and so many toys to play with.
Yes... But until tomorrow, bye-bye.